That's my potion. Turn the precious blood of the Lamb. I've found healing. That's my potion. Turn the precious blood of the Lamb.
I found healing.
That's my portion. It's in the precious blood.
In the precious blood of the Lamb.
I found healing.
I found healing.
That's my portion.
That's my portion.
It's in the precious blood.
In the precious blood of the Lamb.
Say healing flows in the blood. Yes, it is in the blood.
Yes, it is in the blood.
By His stripes we are healed.
By His stripes we are
from
healed.
All sickness and
from
pain.
All sickness.
Healing flows in the blood.
Healing flows in the blood.
Yes, it is in the blood.
Yes, it is in the blood.
By His stripes we are healed. Redemption, that's my portion. Send the precious blood of the Lamb, of the Lamb. I've found redemption. That's my portion. Send the precious blood. In the precious blood of the Lamb, say, I found redemption.
I found redemption.
That's my portion.
That's my portion.
It's in the precious blood.
In the precious blood of the Lamb.
I found redemption. That's my portion. In the precious blood of the Lamb. Redemption flows in the blood.
Yes, it is in the blood.
We have redemption.
Through the blood of the Lamb.
Redemption flows. That's my portion. It's in the precious blood of the Lamb, of the Lamb. I've found salvation. That's my portion. It's in the precious blood. in the precious blood of the Lamb. Oh, 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 oh.
Good morning, family. Good morning, everyone. It's good to see all of you here this morning. I'm excited that we are all together to pray, and we all have joined and woke up this morning. I know it's becoming a little chilly, and you know it's winter, and so it's not as easy as it used to be to wake up in the morning, but we still have to wake up in the morning and make sure that we gather together for prayer. Praise God. It's good to see all of you here. I have seen many of you are saying good morning. Good morning, Pastor. Good morning, family. It's good to see all of you here this morning. Praise God. So make sure that, if you know someone who is not up as yet, just send them a WhatsApp or send them whatever it is that you need to send them and just say, hey, hello, good morning. Wake up, wake up, wake up. It's time for prayer. It's time for prayer. So it's important that we continue to pray, and I'm going to share about a little bit about that today, because that's what Jesus did all the time. Praise God. Well, without any waste of time, I would like us to turn our Bibles to the book of Luke chapter 22. I want to read from verse 39 all the way to verse 46. Luke chapter 22, verse 39 to verse 46. If your Bible is like mine, or if you are reading from your computer or from any other version, it also gives you the heading of that particular passage of scripture, or that particular, or those verses. In my case, it says Jesus prays on the Mount of Olives, so that's the kind of like heading on top of those verses. Jesus prays on the Mount of Olives. Verse 39, it says, Jesus went out as usual to the Mount of Olives, and his disciples followed him. So when it says as usual, that means that's something that he always does. And I was asking myself when I was reading this, yesterday, whether this as usual, going to the Mount of Olives, was related to prayer, or he just liked hanging around Mount of Olives. And obviously, I started, thinking about it deeply and meditating on it. And I realized that, it could have been that this was Jesus' spot of prayer. I don't know. That's not what the Bible says. But I think, that him going to the mountain as usual, I don't think he was just going out there for the views. I think he was going out there, to pray. But anyway, let's go to verse 40. It says, on reaching the place, he said to them, pray that you will not fall into temptation. So he goes to that place and he prays with them. So in verse 41, he says, he withdrew about a stone throw beyond them, knelt down and prayed, Father, if you are willing, take this cup from me, yet not my will, but yours be done. An angel from heaven appeared to him and strengthened him. And being in anguish, he prayed more earnestly, and his sweat was like drops of blood falling to the ground. Verse 45. When he rose from prayer and went back to his disciples, he found them asleep, exhausted from sorrow. Why are you sleepy? He asked them. Get up and pray, so that you will not fall into temptation. I mean, there are many lessons that you and I can learn from these passages of scripture, or from this passage of scripture. There are many lessons and there are many things that we can learn from this. But I want to really just bring out some few things that I think are very important where prayer is concerned. So Jesus is saying to them, pray that you may not fall into temptation. Now, when I read this, I just realized how important prayer is. I've always known, that prayer is very important. I've always placed a lot of emphasis on prayer. And I've always believed that, as believers or as Christians, we are to pray. But when I read this yesterday, where it says that, you know, Jesus said to them, pray that you may not fall into temptation. I thought that, you know, the antidote or me, you know, not falling into temptation is really a function of me praying, or it's in my hands, for lack of a better word. You know, if I am to pray, and if I am to continue praying, I am literally, you know, immunizing myself from falling into temptation. I'm literally helping myself and literally, you know, protecting myself from falling into temptation. Because Jesus says to them very clearly, he says, you know, if you don't want to fall into temptation, this is how you do it. And how do you do it? You do it by prayer, he says. He says, pray that you will not fall into temptation. The Bible says he withdrew, you know, about a stone throw beyond them, knelt down and prayed. So he wanted a place, you know, where he could just be by himself and pray. You know, sometimes you have to, sometimes you have to, you know, get off the riffraff out of your life. You know, get away from everybody else. Get away from your children. Get away from your, you know, from your friends or whoever you are, you know, with all the time. And just be by yourself and get to a place of prayer where it is just you and God and nobody else. You know, because when you are in that position, you are able to pour your heart out. You know, you're not careful about the words you say, that people are listening to you. You're not trying to prove a point. You're not trying to prove to anybody, you know, whether you're using the right words or not, or you know how to pray or not. But you're just pouring yourself out. You're literally becoming real. You know, you're becoming, you're literally saying, Lord, here I am. You know, I am coming to you and I am praying. That's what Jesus says. The Bible says he withdrew about a stone throw beyond them, he knelt and he prayed. Now, if Jesus prayed, what about us? If Jesus, you know, saw and recognized the importance of prayer, what more about us? You know, I mean, it's as clear as daylight right there. It's Jesus prayed. The scripture says, I read in verse 39, Jesus went out as usual to the Mount of Olives. And I told you my interpretation of it to say that as usual, they probably meant that, you know, Jesus went to the Mount of Olives constantly to go and pray. As usual, he would go there. He would go there to pray because he understood that, you know, the very heartbeat and the very essence of his ministry was dependent on this prayer, for him to stay strong, for him to stay, you know, on the cutting edge, for him to, you know, continually do the things that he was doing. It was dependent on prayer. Child of God, I'm asking you a question this morning. Are you willing to do what Jesus did? Are you willing to pray the same way that Jesus prayed? Are you willing to follow in his footsteps in order for you to become victorious or to walk in victory in every step of the way? And this is how we have to live. This is how we need to be conducting our lives. You see, ministry and prayer, I mean, and church and many other things that we do are purely dependent on prayer. The fuel of the things we do in life, the fuel of our victory, let me say that again, the fuel of our victory is prayer. Victory in our lives, victory, you know, in everything we do, victory in our relationships, victory, you know, in our workplaces, victory in our churches, victory over sin, victory over sickness and disease. I believe the fuel of it, or the foundation of it, or the basis, the very foundation of it, what holds it up together, the fuel of it, is prayer. It's prayer. This is what Jesus did. The Bible says he prayed. He prayed. He says, Father, if you are willing, take this cup from me, yet not my will, but yours be done. Now, notice he is praying the same prayer that he prayed when he was in the Garden of Gethsemane. This is prior to him, you know, Judas Iscariot had to come and betray him. This is before the betrayal. This is before, you know, he was brought before Pilate. This is before he was brought before Herod. This is before, you know, he was bitten. This is before he was crucified. This is before everything happened. And he saw all of that in the spirit. And he said, I got to pray about this. You know, when he saw this challenging moment that was coming before him, he did not think about, you know, who do I phone? You know, who do I tell? And so forth. The Bible says he went to the Mount of Olives and he prayed. Child of God, I know there are things that you might be facing right now, child of God. I know there are things that you might be seeing right now in the spirit that might even be coming your way. Child of God, you might be accused as we speak right now of the things that you know you did not do. You know, you might be faced with a very challenging moment, just like Jesus was faced, you know, with the cross. It's not an easy thing. The scripture says that he had to pray. That's why he prayed. He says, let this cup pass away, because he was faced with such a challenging situation. Many of you might be faced with that challenging situation. Some of you might be in that challenging situation right now. What do you do? What do you do, child of God, when you are faced with a shaking, life-threatening, life-shaking situation? What do you do? Well, the scripture tells us what Jesus did right here. The Bible says that Jesus prayed. Jesus prayed. You and I can pray. He prayed, but he said, Lord, it is not my will that I'm seeking, but it is your will. In verse 43, the Bible says, an angel from heaven appeared to him and strengthened him. I believe your strength will be found even as you go to a place of prayer. Let me say that again. Your strength will be found when you go to the place of prayer. Your situation is shaking. Your situation is challenging. Your situation is difficult. But your strength will be found, you know, in a place of prayer. I believe that God has placed angels to strengthen you as long as you activate that mode of prayer. Activate the mode of prayer in your life, child of God. Activate that mode of prayer in your life, child of God, in the name of Jesus. The Bible says, and being in anguish, he prayed more earnestly, and his sweat was like drops of blood falling to the ground. Let me tell you something. You know, when you pray, it's not always an easy thing. You know, when you pray, sometimes you have to pray some more. Even when you don't feel like praying, you gotta pray some more. There are times when you need to pray and keep pressing and keep pushing. And that's why, you know, I like those people who say, push until something happens. Prayer, you know, stands for pushing until something happens. And that's what Jesus did. The scripture says that he prayed more earnestly. More earnestly. He prayed some more. He prayed some more. And that's what we are, you know, we are to do. What Jesus did, we are to do it. If he got his victory, like I said earlier on, if he became victorious through prayer, we will be victorious through prayer as well. So the Bible says he prayed some more and he sweat. He was even sweating right there. He was even sweating. And the Bible says his sweat was like drops of blood falling to the ground. This represents, you know, being serious about prayer and really, really giving himself to prayer. You can see that he was pushing. He was really, really pushing. And you and I are to do that. And Jesus says, this is the way to victory. This is the way, you know, to make things, to be victorious. I believe that, you know, Jesus, even when he was faced with the cross and he had to go through all those challenges that he was facing, fact that, you know, he did not even answer when Pilate asked him certain questions. He answered once. He said, you know, when Pilate said to him, I understand that you are the king of the Jews. And Jesus says, I am. And then from there, he had the wisdom not to answer certain questions that were asked him, and many other things that took place when they were spitting on him and doing all sorts of things. You know, he did not retaliate. I believe, you know, it was a function of prayer. I believe that Jesus, you know, remained strong because he prayed about this situation. You will remain strong. Listen to me, child of God. Listen to me. You will remain strong because you prayed or because you are prayerful. Whatever that comes your way, you will be able to handle it with grace because you are prayerful. We will be able to handle things gracefully so because we are prayerful people. When sickness or disease comes our way, we will be able to handle it gracefully because we are prayerful. You know, when we are shaken to the core, we will be able to handle every situation gracefully because we are prayerful. We are prayerful people. Jesus did the same. Jesus is teaching us a lesson here that he was able to handle those things that he was able to handle because he was prayerful. In verse 45, the Bible says, when he rose from prayer and went back to his disciples, he found them asleep, exhausted from sorrow. Sorrow exhausted them. I know there are times when I hear people say, Pastor George, I can't even pray. I'm under so much pressure, I cannot even pray. I know those moments happen. I know those moments happened to me. There were times in my life where I just did not know what to say to God. When those moments happen, or when those moments come your way, you cannot afford to let go of the weapon of prayer. You cannot afford to let go of prayer. Prayer is core. Jesus prayed until, the Bible says, his sweat was like drops of blood falling to the ground. You and I cannot afford to let go of this weapon of prayer. If you don't know what to say anymore, just say Jesus. Jesus, 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 I love you, Lord. I'm praying. If you don't know what to say anymore, you know, you and I even have the luxury of the Holy Spirit. If you don't know what to say anymore, pray in the Spirit. Get into the Spirit and pray in the Holy Ghost. Pray in the Holy Ghost. Pray in tongues. Pray in tongues. As you pray in tongues, you know, the Spirit of God is helping you to pray. For the Bible says your mind is unfruitful, but your spirit is praying. Your spirit is praying. So that's what you need to do. You know, we have that luxury. We are empowered with the Holy Ghost. Jesus found his disciples asleep. They were exhausted from sorrow. They were sorrowful. And they could not pray anymore. What did he say to them? What did he do to them? The scripture says, he asked them a question. He says, why are you sleeping? Why are you sleeping? It's not time to be sleeping. He asked them, get up and pray so that you will not fall into temptation. He repeats it again. He says, if you are not to fall into temptation, I need you to get up right now and pray. Get up and pray, child of God. Get up and pray. Get up and pray so that you don't fall into temptation. Some of you, you need to be WhatsApping or sending people messages right now, those of you who are here, and say, get up and pray. Get up and pray. Get up and pray. It's important. And this is something that we have to do, you know, as some form of a tradition. We have to pray all the time because prayer is what keeps us moving. Prayer is what keeps us from falling into temptation. Prayer is the fuel that we need in our Christian lives. That's how powerful prayer is. Jesus did it. We can do it. Jesus lived a life of prayer, so you and I can live a life of prayer. Whether it's winter, whether it's autumn, whether it's, you know, spring or summer, we got to be people of prayer. We don't say that we prayed for 17 years. You know, oh, Pastor George, I've been born again right now for 40 years. I have been praying. I have prayed so many prayers. I don't think, you know, it's necessary for me to pray. Hey, listen, Jesus prayed all the time. And you and I can pray. As a matter of fact, the Bible says he's sitting at the right-hand side of the Father, making intercessions for you and me. The Bible says that God gave us the Spirit, God gave us the Holy Spirit to come and help us. And one of the things that he helps us with, the Holy Spirit helps us with, is helping us in prayer. What does the Bible say? The Bible says, for we do not know what we should pray for as we ought. But he, the Spirit of God, helps us in our infirmities. So the Holy Spirit has been given to assist us in prayer. Jesus is praying for us at the right hand side of the Father. And he tells us to pray. And that's how he did things when he was here on earth. Oh man, this is powerful. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And I just hope that this broadcast came out without any glitches, you know, of cutting off and stuff like that, because this is what he wants us to do. He wants us to pray, praise God. If it means that you need to go and watch this broadcast again, you go ahead and you watch this broadcast again, praise God. So he prayed, you and I can pray. And so tonight, or this morning, not tonight, but this morning, we are going to pray. Well, it's still dark where I am, but you know, it's morning. So we're going to pray. We're going to ask God today that, Lord, at our church, House of Faith, we are having, you know, a Good Friday services. We are having a service on Friday at 10 o'clock in the morning. We're having a service 1800 hours, which is 6 o'clock p.m. on Saturday. And we're having Dr. David Moluzzi coming to preach on that Saturday. And we are also having our Resurrection Sunday, 9 o'clock on Sunday. So we are going to pray for these services. I want us to pray for these services. You know, these services will be effective and will become effective if you and I are going to pray and undergird them with prayer. So we're going to pray today for our services this coming weekend, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. And not only do we pray for our services, but we are going to pray for other people's services. I know that there are services going on everywhere. I know, for example, at Grace Bible Church, Bishop Mosasono, who is our spiritual father, is having these services as well, you know, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. They will be having services, you know, on Friday at Orlando Stadium, Saturday as well at Orlando Stadium, and Sunday as well. So we're going to pray for, you know, their services. We're going to pray for many other people's services. As Good Friday is here, the Passover is here, so we're going to pray and just keep on praying that many people may, you know, come in contact with God, and many people can give their lives to Jesus during these services. These services, you know, are a reminder to us of what Jesus did on the cross, or Jesus went through even as he was going to the cross. So we're going to pray that God may just, you know, walk and do great things where these services are concerned, in Jesus' name. And that's what we're going to pray. So we're also going to pray that, you know, people may be born again during these services, that we may see people being born again, people being healed, and people being released from their bondages, and people being freed from all kinds of things that are binding them, that, you know, it may be a moment of victory and a moment of breakthrough, in Jesus' name. So that's what we're going to pray today. And you can pray with us, and we are going to have a great time. Is that all right? Father, we bless your name this morning. We thank you, Lord, for what you have done. The Bible says that Jesus, as usual, went to the Mount of Olives, and his disciples followed him. The scripture says when he reached on that mountain, he prayed, that he said to his disciples, pray that you may not fall into temptation. And the Bible says that he withdrew about a stone throw beyond them. He knelt down and he prayed. And he prayed that, Father, if you are willing, let this cup, you know, pass me by. Take this cup from me, yet not my will, but your will. He prayed on that mountain. And Heavenly Father, we are praying this morning. For Jesus said, if we pray, that we will not fall into temptation. The Bible says that prayer is something that we got to do all the time. We come before you today in the precious holy name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We are praying, oh God, that Father, even as we are having these services, this Good Friday service, the Saturday service, Lord, and the Sunday, Resurrection Sunday service, Lord, we are praying in the name of Jesus, that these services, oh God, may be life-changing. We are praying that these services, oh God, may be life-altering in the name of Jesus. We are praying, oh God, that your presence may fill these services, Lord, that we may see many, oh God, come to Jesus in the name of Jesus, that we may see many touched, healed, and delivered, Lord, from the bondages of sin and from the bondages of the devil in the name of Jesus. Father, we are praying that let your power and let your glory, O God, be seen. Father, we are praying that many people, even those who don't normally go to church, Father, we are praying that on this Friday, this Saturday, and this Sunday, that they may come to church, O God, in the name of Jesus. Father, we are praying that you may visit them. We are praying today in the name of Jesus that the Holy Spirit may touch them, O God, in Jesus' name, that they may go to church, O God, and not only go to church, O God, but they may have a meaningful encounter with you, Lord, in Jesus' name. I pray that, Lord, let something supernatural take place in their lives in the name of Jesus. I'm praying, oh God, that you touch them, that you heal them, Lord. That, Lord, in Jesus' name, that they may have a revelation, Lord, of your word. Revelation of what you have done for them, oh God. That they may understand, oh God, what happened on that cross, Lord. That they may understand the love that you have for them in the name of Jesus. Father, I pray that you draw them in, oh God. Draw them, my God, to various churches. Draw them, my God, to our building at 130 Plantation Road in Blue Hills, Midrand, Lord. Draw them, let them come. I pray, God, for the community of Blue Hills. I am praying for the people of Midrand. I'm praying, God, for the people of Gauteng, oh God. I'm praying, Lord, in Jesus' name, even for our neighboring cities. I'm praying for them in the name of Jesus. I pray that they may come by their numbers, Lord. I pray that hundreds of people, God, may come, Lord, and flock in, Lord, that we may not even have room for them in the name of Jesus, that they may hear, God, the gospel of Jesus Christ. I pray for this great revival, Lord, that you have started even in our church. I'm praying that let this revival continue, oh God, to touch and to flow in the lives of people. I am praying for our neighbors. I'm praying for our community, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Let there be a visitation, Lord, in the name of Jesus from heaven. Father, I pray that you visit your people. I pray, God, in the name of Jesus, that, Lord, they may be reminded, God, in Jesus' name, of what happened on Calvary, Lord. Let them be reminded, God, of your goodness. Let them be reminded of your love, Lord. Let them be reminded that, Lord, you loved them so much and you still love them so much that you gave your life, Lord, in the name of Jesus, to be crucified. You gave your body to be crucified, Lord. You gave yourself, Lord, to hang on that cross, Lord, not for you, but for us. Heavenly Father, I pray that let there be this consciousness, Lord, about people understanding about your love and knowing, God, the sacrifice that you had done, oh God, for us to live today. Heavenly Father, I am praying in the name of Jesus that even those who don't normally go to church, Lord, let them be reminded of this, Lord. Let them gather strength, Lord. Loose them from the chains of Satan, oh God, that they may come, Lord, in Jesus' name, and hear the word of the Lord. Come and gather with us, Lord, even as we celebrate what you have done on that cross in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, I am praying today. I am praying today for your people, God. I'm praying, God, in Jesus' name, that, Lord, let them come from the east. Let them come from the north. Let them come from the south. Let them come from everywhere, oh God, in Jesus' name. I pray, God, for record-breaking numbers of people coming to church in Jesus' name. This, my God, this Good Friday, Lord. I am praying, even on Saturday and even on Sunday, Lord, I'm praying that let this weekend, my God, be a record-breaking weekend, God, where church attendance and God salvations are concerned. My salvations is my prayer. I am praying, God, in Jesus' mighty name for every single one, oh God. We give you the praise, oh Lord. We pray, God, for those spouses of people that have never gone to church. Father, I pray they go to church for the first time. Those, oh God, those children, oh God, who have been running away from prayer, Lord, from going to church, I pray that they may come to church in the name of Jesus. Every single person, Lord, I am praying, God, that in this nation, in our nation, South Africa, and the nations of the world, I am praying, God, that we may have many people going to church, many people being reminded of the love of God. many people be reminded of how much he loved us and he still loves us. In Jesus' mighty name. Father, we give you the praise. We give you the honor. Oh, rana rasi telebe keshandarabasa. Mandarabakoshe telebo goriandarabasa. Father, we bless your name. Father, I pray, God, not only just in our church, but I pray, God, that, Lord, even at the stadium, Lord, at Orlando Stadium, where Grace is going to have the services, Lord, let there be a record-breaking services, Lord, even at this at the stadium, Lord. I pray for in various churches. I know Pastor Art Boshoff is going to be having a service even at the stadium, at the Super Park. Stadium, Lord. I pray, God, in Jesus' name, that let there be a record-breaking numbers of people going there, Lord. Let there be a record-breaking numbers of people coming to our church, God, the numbers that we have never heard before, in the name of Jesus. Let there be a record-breaking, God, attendance like we have never seen before. Not only in our church, House of Faith, but, Lord, we are praying that let this be a worldwide movement, oh God, in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' name, in churches, my God, in small places, in classrooms, those churches, oh God, in tents, those churches, God, everywhere, let there be a record-breaking numbers of people going to church, my God, this Friday, this Saturday, and this Sunday, in the name of Jesus. Father, we give you the praise. Father, we give you the honor. Oh, ratalasi teleboshia. In the name of Jesus. We bless your name, O God. We pray, Father, I pray that even as people come, that they may have an encounter with Jesus. I pray, God, in Jesus' name, that people may be healed, O God. I pray that people may understand and realize the love of God, the love that you have for them, Lord, in Jesus' name. Father, we give you the praise. We give you the honor, for you are wonderful and precious, O Lord, in Jesus' name, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We worship you, Lord. We praise you. Oh, Rababashi Telebosian. We praise your God. We glorify your name. For your name is above every other name. In Jesus' name I pray. Thank you, Lord. I give you the glory and I give you the honor. And it's in Jesus' name I pray. Father, I pray today also for me as I'm one of the speakers, oh God, speaking in our conference, Lord. This weekend, Father, I'm also praying for Dr. Maluzzi, oh God. I pray that you use us mightily. I pray, God, for our worship team. I pray for every single one that is going to participate, Lord, in these services. I pray that, Lord, you may use us mightily. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Praise God. Father, we are so grateful today. In Jesus' name, I'm grateful that all of you have joined with us this morning. And we are looking forward to meeting with you tonight at 130 Plantation Road, Blue Hills, Midrand. We're going to have a great, great, great time together. So please come and join with us. Call others. It's going to be a time of Bible study and also a time of prayer. Come on, let's continue praying. That's what Jesus said we must do, you know, and let's continue praying. So let's meet tonight there. Those that you know that were not part of this prayer meeting, please encourage them to come tonight in Jesus' name, even as we're going to continue to pray, you know, for our services that are coming this weekend. So it's going to be a great weekend. It's going to be a powerful, powerful weekend. So join with us even as we celebrate, you know, what Jesus did. In Jesus' name, God bless you. See you tonight. Amen and amen.